Dear students, previous class we will discuss about mineral nutrition in essential elements. How many types of essential elements? Two types of essential elements based on the quantitative requirements. Those two essential elements are here. First one, macro elements are macro nutrients. Second one, micro element or micro nutrient. 17 essential elements are here. Of these, 9 macro elements are macro nutrients, and 8 micro elements and micro nutrients. Dear students, today we will discuss about the role of macro elements or macro nutrients. Okay, dear students. Macro elements are here 9, but 3 elements are in non-mineral elements such as carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. Remaining 6 are macro mineral elements, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur. Dear students, 3 are non-mineral elements or framework elements or structural elements of a cell. Structural elements of a cell. These 3 elements are here carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. To be making one carbohydrate or one glucose or one type of sugar. So these 3 elements are three non-mineral elements to be obtained from atmospheric carbon dioxide and atmospheric water, that is CO2 and H2O. Okay, now next coming to discuss about remaining macro elements, that is nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, magnesium, sulfur. We will discuss about 1 by 1. So first macro element, that is nitrogen. So dear students, nitrogen are also available from the soil, and then after this nitrogen directly not enter the plants. So this nitrogen to be converted, first nitrite, then will be converted nitrate, finally converted ammonium, finally converted ammonium. Dear students, nitrogen is one of the essential macro mineral element available from the soil. Then after this nitrogen not directly enter the plants. So this nitrogen is converted to nitrite NO3-, then after converted to nitrate NO2-, and finally converted to ammonium, that is NH4+. This nitrogen to be utilizing all parts of the plant. Why? Because nitrogen is the major essential mineral element required by the plants. So this is a good quantitative. Okay, now. So this nitrogen, what is the role of nitrogen? So this nitrogen, major constituent of proteins, nucleic acids, vitamins, and hormones. This nitrogen is rich in all parts of the plant. At the same time, this nitrogen to be making of proteins, nucleic acids, that is DNA, RNA, vitamins, phosphorus to be making a cell membrane and to be making a proteins as well as to be making a nucleic acids. So dear students, nitrogen and phosphorus both are very very essential to be plants. These two are very very essential elements and play a similar role that is nitrogen, phosphorus and another one are here third element potassium. So potassium is absorbed from potassium, that is divalent cation, that is K plus, and this potassium only occurs in vegetable tissues, leaves and buds. This potassium to be utilized in meristematic tissues, leaves and also buds. What is the role of potassium? So dear students, potassium is a maintenance of anion cation balance in cells, opening and closing of stomata and activation of enzymes. Potassium play a major role, that is always maintains of anion cation balance in cells. Positive charge of anions and negative charge of cations to be equilibrium is always balance and the opening and closing of stomata. So some plants stomata is opening during daytime, some plants stomata is opening during night time, depend upon to the concentration of potassium. Influx reflux of potassium and activation of enzymes. So several enzymes to be involved in photosynthesis respiration process. These enzymes are activated by potassium. Okay, here and fourth element are here calcium. So in this calcium to be absorbed in form Ca2 plus. That is divalent calcium ion. So this calcium to be using of the meristematic and differentiation of cells. Calcium to be utilized into meristematic tissues and differentiation of the cells. Meristematic tissue is divided into number of cells. These cells to be make a one part of the plant body structure. And what is the role of calcium? This calcium is always synthesis of cell wall, formation of magnetic spindle fibers and photolysis of water. Cell is covered by a protective layer, that is cell wall. Cell wall is made is always calcium and formation of magnetic spindle fibers. One mother cell is divided into two daughter cells. These two daughter cells to be separated one pole to another pole is always to be move opposite poles within the help of spindle fibers. These spindle fibers to be make a calcium and photolysis of water. Dear students, the spitting of water and to be liberating oxygen due to photosynthesis, that is called photolysis of water. In this reaction are involved calcium. Okay, now the water is splitting and to liberating of oxygen during the photosynthesis, that is called photolysis of water. Next fifth element are here magnesium. Magnesium is available from Mg2+. This is a divalent cation and in which part of the plants? All parts of the plants. Magnesium is also useful in all parts of the plants. What is the role of magnesium? So this magnesium is always activation of enzymes in photosynthesis and respiration processes. So this magnesium is always activation of enzymes that is C3 cycle, C4 cycle, CAM cycle, as well as glycolysis and respiration process. Glycolysis and respiration process. This process are to be utilized into several enzymes. These several enzymes are to be activated on the element that is magnesium. That is magnesium. And at the same time, synthesis of DNA and RNA. Nucleic acids are of two types, that is DNA and RNA. So this DNA and RNA to be synthesized by magnesium. To be synthesized by magnesium. As well as, so the magnesium to be constituted within the chlorophyll. Constituted within the chlorophyll and to be make a ribosome structure. To be make a ribosome structure. That is the role of magnesium. That is the role of magnesium. And next, last sixth element are here, sulfur. So, sulfur is absorbed from sulfate. So, all plants is not directly receiving of the sulfur. This sulfur is converted to sulfate ion. This sulfur is converted to sulfate ion. So, this sulfate ion to be placed in all parts of the plants. All parts of the plants. And what is the role of sulfur? So this sulfur mainly constitutes within the two amino acids. These two amino acids are very very important, such as cysteine and methionine. Cysteine and methionine. At the same time, the sulfur to be activated of coenzymes. Activated of coenzymes. Common enzymes are here and coenzymes are here. Such as coenzymes NAD plus, FAD plus, NADH and FADH2. So NAD plus nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide, FAD flavonoidine dinucleotide. These two are very very important coenzymes. These coenzymes is always activated by sulfur. And sulfur to be forming disulfur bridges. These disulfur bridges to be making a one protein structure. One protein structure. Dear students, this is about the role of macro elements or macro nutrients. So, dear students, totally 9 macro elements are here, but 3 are non-mineral elements or framework elements or structural elements of a cell. But remaining 6 are very very useful essential macro elements. Of these, 3 are very very essential macro elements, such as nitrogen.